MorphMarket has spared no expense to create the perfect interface for you to manage all of your animal data. Our new inventory page, which is now referred to as the Animal Manager, has been built from scratch with a professional design that you'll love. It supports both animals which are for sale as well as those which are not for sale. With this new system, any reptile keeper can manage all of their animal data. In this video, I'm going to give you a tour of the new interface so you can take advantage of all the new features. But don't worry, you don't need to understand all of these tips in order to be successful. So let's dig in. At first glance, the Animal Manager looks similar to its predecessor, the Inventory. You have a page with rows which represent animals, and columns represent attributes of those animals. Some are the same as before, such as title, price, birth, sex, maturity, traits, and so forth. If we slide to the right, you can see some additional familiar fields such as impressions, clicks, and inquiries. However, there's a number of additional columns as well, such as an image column, a status column, and dam and sire columns. Like before, we find actions on the right-hand side, which include edit animal, renew, change status, and under the menu, public view, duplicate, and remove. One of the most powerful things about the Animal Manager is its customizability. Vertically, the old manager showed 50 rows. The new one shows 10 by default so that they always fit on a normal desktop screen. However, you can change this to 20, 50, or even 100. Horizontally, as you've noticed, there's quite a few columns. On a device, it's easy to drag and slide back and forth, and on desktop, you can shift mouse wheel to move back and forth. However, there may be some columns that are really important for you to see, and you can customize which ones are shown and what order they're shown in. So let's just say that we want to save some space by hiding date of birth, sex, maturity, and weight, quantity, and maybe clutch ID is something really important to you. So we can use the up arrow and move that item all the way to whatever column we want to place it in. We also have a couple of bonus columns, category and title and ID, in case you would prefer those to title and category, as we have here with a separate animal ID column. These settings are stored, so each time you visit the site with your desktop, the same settings will be remembered. Or if you come with your mobile phone, it will store a different set of settings, so you can customize it for each different layout. Let's look at three different ways you can explore your data within the manager. The first is with search. There's a search bar at the top here, and we can type in a keyword which will match across animal title, animal ID, clutch ID, and even the MorphMarket ID number. So let's type in exanthic. We could add another keyword for SK, or another one for clown. Touching the search input also allows us to add filters of other sorts. For example, if we wanted to filter down to animals that had anywhere from one to, say, three traits, we could enter them in like that. And then if we wanted to change the filter, we can just touch the bubble, and we could even remove it by clicking on the X. If we wanted to match animals that had exactly one trait, we could say one-to-one. Across the top of the table, we find column headers, which can be clicked in order to sort our data. By default, they're sorted by last updated, so we see the animals we've modified most recently first. If we want to sort by animal ID, we could click on that column. If we want to reverse the sort, we just click it again. If we wanted to see the youngest animals in this collection, we can click on birth. Sorting is also useful to find unset values. For example, if we click on the image column, then it will sort to the top all of the animals without images. One of the most exciting parts about the new Animal Manager is enhanced status, which gives you more control over how you organize your animal data. You can see status in this column in the middle of the page, and it is represented by three parts. The first is state, the second is visibility, and the third is whether it's enabled or not. We can see all of the status values if we use the status filter. States include for sale, on hold, sold, not for sale, loaned, and archived. For visibility, we have three choices: public, unlisted, and private. Unlisted would mean that if you provided the link to your animal to someone else, they could view it, but it won't be included in our search engine. If an animal is set to private, it's only visible to you. The third part of status is enabled, and this can be set to active, inactive, or expired. You might have noticed that at the top of this page, there are tabs, and this is a quick way to change the state of the animals you're looking for. Collection contains all your animals which are for sale, on hold, as well as not for sale and loaned. And of course, all contains all your animals. From each of these tabs, you can then apply filters to further narrow down the animals you're viewing. Many of you like to use spreadsheets to manage your data, and we understand why. Spreadsheets are great because they allow you to both view and modify list data all in one place. For that reason, the Animal Manager will allow you to perform the most common editing operations without ever leaving this page. First, it supports inline editing for 8 different columns, including image, title, price, status, weight, maturity, quantity, and clutch ID. Let's say that we wanted to update the weights of our animals. We might want to first sort by some other column, such as animal ID, so that as we change the weights, they don't move around. It looks like we have a lot of weights to update here, but all we have to do is touch the cell and enter in a value. We can also just back that out if we want to. We can also change other columns like status. By clicking on status, we could change this animal to on hold, sold, and so forth, or change its visibility or set it to inactive. We can also add images to our animals without ever leaving this page. One way is to click on the thumbnail in the image column. From there, you can select an image and it's uploaded. Another way is, if you're on a desktop, to simply drag and drop one or more images onto the row. You can see that on the thumbnail there's a number which indicates how many images have been uploaded to that animal. Editing values from this page is great, but sometimes you want to edit more than one value at once. And this is where bulk actions come in. On the left column, we can select one or more rows using the checkbox. And then from the bulk actions menu, we can do things like renew ads, remove them, or change any number of fields in bulk. We can also select all of the values on this page with this checkbox at the very top. And if we want to select all the pages, the entire inventory, we click on this gold link in the middle of the page. Now 40 items are selected, even though only 10 are shown on this screen. How about we mark all of John's animals down by 50%? We can change the price to a specific value, or we can decrease it by a percent. Sorry, John, your animals are going on sale. Just kidding. In this video, we've shown you how the Animal Manager can help you more efficiently explore, organize, and manage your animal data. As I mentioned, you don't need to use all of these tips in order to be successful. If it feels overwhelming, just keep using the same workflows that you have in the past. Try to incorporate one new tip, like maybe dragging and dropping images onto the Animal Manager screen. Later, you can watch this video again when you're more familiar with the system, and incorporate another time-saving change. If you really get stuck, you can still access the old inventory with a link near the top of the page. But please do reach out to support@morphmarket.com if you need any help. In the coming months, you'll see us applying the same style and features to other parts of the site. Soon, we'll add an offspring page which will allow you to track all of your clutches and litters. Also, we plan to add support for custom traits and labels. Make sure to watch the other two videos in this series on establishing lineage within your collection and utilizing NFS animal pages, and also on the new dashboard, which will help you track and monitor all of your animal data. It's our pleasure to serve you.